Everyone is focused on immersive 180 videos for Apple Vision Pro. But why is no one talking about immersive 180 photography? In this tutorial, I will break new ground by showing you how to capture, edit, view, and share stunning 3D 180 photos in top quality using camera like the Canon R5 Mark II right here with the 3D lens, or the more affordable Canon R7 with the new autofocus dual fisheye lens. If you want to learn how to photograph your own spatial memories or view others immersive 3D 180 photos like our recent release of famous painting from the loop on Apple Vision Pro, this tutorial is for you. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. First, let's dive into how to capture 3D 180 immersive photos. Unfortunately, AI isn't quite there yet, so you will need a 3D 180 camera. But hey, if you know something I don't, comment and prove me wrong. For now, you will need a camera like the Canon R5, R5C, the new R5 Mark II right here, or my personal favorite, the Canon R7 with the new Dual Fisheye Lens. Now, why the R7? It's smaller, museum friendly, doesn't scream professional video camera, has 3D autofocus, and best of all, is very affordable. I have done an in-depth review on it, which you can check it out right here. The R7 captures 7K 3D 180 photos, which is the minimum size requirement for a good immersive experience. On the other hand, the R5 Mark II can generate stunning 16K 3D 180 photos with the help of machine learning, giving you the highest quality for viewing on Apple Vision Pro. If you are curious about that, I have got a review for the R5 Mark II right here. So think this R7 as your travel-friendly budget option and the R5 Mark II as your high-end professional solution. To get the best quality, always capture in RAW. But here is the problem. The official Canon EOS VR utility can only process JPEG files, not CR3 RAW files, even with the latest 14.10 version. Yes, the one with the new logo that required for the R5 Mark II to work, it still can't handle RAW. Luckily for you, you are following Hugh, Ho, and Kimchi. We always had the solutions. If you try to process your Canon RAW file with the Adobe Camera RAW and the Photoshop, the output wouldn't be recognized by EOS VR utility. The trick here is to pass all the 3D 180 camera metadata from the RAW into JPEG, and we are going to do that using Adobe Lightroom Classic. First, import your Canon RAW photo into Lightroom, go to the Developer module, and do your usual RAW photo editing. One key step, under Lens Profile, make sure to check Remove Chromatic Aberration. All official lens suffer from this, so let Adobe fix that for you. Now, let's talk about denoising. Adobe's AI denoise in RAW is still a lot better than Topaz Photo AI for this. Hit denoise, and for a daytime photo like this, setting it around 60 should do the trick. Once you are done, go to File, hit Export, choose your save location, and set the image format to JPEG with 100% image quality. The crucial part here is under Metadata, set it to All Metadata, and uncheck everything else. Now export your JPEG. Bring that JPEG into EOS VR utility, and voila, it's recognized. You will see a big improvement over the in-camera JPEG. The only thing missing is the horizontal correction, as the draw data didn't carry over, but you can manually adjust that with this slider right here. Plus, you still get the lens mask feature, which is super helpful. By the way, the new EOS VR utility 14.10 is really powerful. If you can afford the subscription, go for it. If not, there's always the DaVinci Resolve alternative workflow, which also work with the Canon RAW photos. Now, since this was shot on the Canon R5 Mark II, it is already a 16K image. Export it and you are ready to view it on the Apple Vision Pro. But what if you don't use Adobe? Another option is Affinity Photo 2, When you export your JPEG, just make sure to check embed metadata and you are good to go. In the Canon R5 Mark II, you can use machine learning to upscale the photo to 16K right in the camera. I already have a tutorial on that, so be sure to check that out. But what if you are using the R7 or R5C? Don't worry, we can use Topaz Photo AI to upscale your final image to 16K. It looks just as good. If you haven't tried Topaz Photo AI yet, check out the link down below. It helps support Kimchi and me, especially after he recently broke my Dual Fisheye Lens. When you are in Topaz Photo AI, only use the upscale feature, not the noise or sharpening, since we already handled that at the raw level in Adobe Lightroom. Set it to 2x or timing 16,000 exactly. I prefer high fidelity V2, but try different options depend on your subjects. Fisheye lenses tend to be a bit blurry, so increase the de-blur just slightly, then go ahead and export your image as JPEG. Now that you have a high quality 3D 180 immersive photos, how do you view them on the Apple Vision Pro? First, use iCloud Drive to transfer your photos to your Vision Pro. Right now, there are three visionOS apps that let you view immersive 180 photos: Kandao XR, Reality Player, and Skybox. The first app is free, Kandao XR. Kandao XR is a versatile MV/HEVC player that can play back spatial video, immersive 180 video in MV/HEVC, 360 videos, and now it also supports 3D 180 photo up to 16K resolution. To view your photo in Kandao XR, open the app, go to Local, File, find the iCloud Drive, and download the 16K 3D 180 photo to your Vision Pro local hard drive. You will need to tell Canon XR what type of photo is, tap 3D, select left and right, then tap the immersive icon right here to enter 180 mode. The result looks fantastic and truly immersive. Obviously, you can't see 3D on YouTube, but if you download my example 3D 1D photos, you will see exactly what I'm seeing. I have provided free sample photos for you to try. Give them a go and let me know what you think in the comment section down below. However, Kandao XR isn't the easiest to use. Every time you load a new photo, you will need to set the left and right eyes and tap immersive mode again. For something more user-friendly, I recommend Skybox. This is a newer visionOS player app, and while it's not free, it costs around $10, it's absolutely worth it. With Skybox, you can stream your immersive video and photo directly from your PC or Mac to your Vision Pro using SMB or AirStream, as long as both devices are on the same Wi-Fi. And it's fast, much faster than iCloud, almost instantaneously with no waiting. Another major benefit is that it saves space on your Vision Pro and iCloud, which in turn saves you money on extra cloud storage. Running out of space on your Vision Pro? Skybox is your solution. Setting up Skybox is super simple. Just download the free client on your Mac or PC, click Add, then point to the folder where your local media is stored. Put on your Vision Pro, open Skybox, and tap the Wi-Fi icon. It should automatically find your Mac or PC. If it doesn't, make sure your computer is connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your Vision Pro. When connected, you can open folder directly from your computer. For example, I stored all my 16K 3D 180 photos in this folder. Open the folder, tap on the first photo, and Skybox will automatically recognize it as a 3D 180 photos and display correctly. It even functions like a slideshow, automatically playing the next photo after 5 seconds and looping once it reaches the end. This is perfect for showcasing your immersive 180 photos to your friends and family without having to teach them how to use the app or Vision Pro. They can just sit back, relax, and get teleported to the Louvre in Paris, just like what you're seeing right now. And if you want to see all the famous paintings in the Louvre, head to the Patreon link in the description and purchase our 180 photo pack. All proceeds go into Kimchi Foundation, which help fund our next immersive 180 film. So it's a win-win for everyone, even Kimchi. Finally, let's talk about distribution. How do you share your incredible 3D 1D photos with the world? The best way is through WebXR on the Safari immersive browser. It's key to showcasing your work in an immersive way that anyone with a Vision Pro can experience it. I have got an in-depth WebXR tutorial right here. Definitely check it out. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you never miss out on future spatial content. And follow me on Instagram to stay updated on everything immersive. I will see you in the WebXR tutorial right here or in spatial. Until then, keep creating and keep exploring. Ciao.